Mom, holidays are so important to a family.
Marilyn, I know they are. I really do. We'll have Christmas together, all right?
No, Mom, I don't want to wait until Christmas. You and Dad promised that you would try and get along.
Marilyn, this is not the time to test the waters between you.
I think it's the perfect time.
No. And I think, for the first time in his life, Tom would agree with me.
No, no, he won't.
Yes, Mary Lynn, no.
Look, I'm sorry, but you obviously do not know how your father feels about that. He loves it. Mom, all these years, Dad has worked very hard to make Thanksgiving Day a very special occasion for me. He knew that I was very sad about not having a mother around. Well, now I do. I have Mom, and I have family. And I want to share my joy with both of you. Now, is that too much to ask? I mean, can't you try and get along?
There is so much unresolved pain.
I'm not asking you to fall in love again. I'm just asking you to try and be friends, Mom. Please. Please just try and be a family. Please say you'll be there.
All right, all right, all right. I will be there.
Thank you so much.
Now, what other reason would John have to know those numbers?
I don't know. Maybe my mother gave them to him.
Yeah, or maybe he is the gigolo.
He's not. Oh, come on, there has got to be some explanation here.
If there is an explanation, I wish you would tell me, Cassie, because to tell the truth, when we started this whole business about looking up John's past, I didn't expect to find anything. It was just a lark. But now I have to say I'm worried, because the facts in those files don't lie. And the fact is that John just might turn out to be a criminal.
No, the fact is, John told me that he loves me, and I believe him.
Where are your bank books?
They're at his place.
Have you looked at them recently?
No, why should I? Look, John would never do this to me. I'm telling you, he wouldn't.
Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Linda?
I just came here because Cassie left her scarf in my car, and I wanted to make sure she got it. There you go, honey.
Thanks. Thanks for the bagels.
Take care of yourself.
Okay.
Bye. Bye, John.
Bye, Melinda. So.
Hi.
What you working on?
Bills.
Yeah?
Yeah. What are you so happy about? Did you win a turkey in a raffle or something?
Nope. Something even better. Yeah? I got a tip on a hot stock that's going to take off like a supersonic jet.
Who gave you this tip?
Burke.
Burke, the man whose wife has been running around on him.
Yeah.
Really? The man who couldn't figure out for 6 months that his wife was cheating on him, and you're going to take a hot stock tip from the guy?
You got it.
I didn't realize that you had such an interest in the market.
Well, there's a lot of things about me you don't know. And I've always been a speculator. The fact is, I've made quite a few killings. Now, I wonder how long it's going to take me to sell my place.
Sell it?
Well, yeah. If I can triple my money, I could buy another condo, we could buy a house in the country.
John, I don't know that much about real estate, but I do know that I don't think you could unload the loft in just a day or two.
Well, yeah, I guess you're right. Damn, I hate to pass up on a sure thing like that. But I guess it takes money to make money, huh? Well, Cassie, where are you going?
I just remembered an appointment I forgot about. Bye.
Our hero, huh?
How you doing, Tom? Let's play down the hero thing, all right? I just happened to be in the right place at the right time, and I got my camera in focus.
Yeah, I still think you're a hero. By the way, I'm terribly sorry to hear about your father.
Oh, yeah, thanks. He's hanging in there right now.
Yeah, good. Still think he had a lot of guts testifying for the grand jury.
Well, I've had my share of courtroom drama in the past few months, but if my testimony will help put this guy away, then I'm more willing to do it.
Well, look, feel free to say anything you want. Tell any stories at all you have from behind the camera, that kind of thing.
Yeah, okay, I wanted to ask you about that. You sure people are going to be real interested in about hearing me as a photographer?
Gordon. 95% of the viewing audience have taken pictures themselves, right? newspaper.
Yeah.
You're going to find this very interesting.
Great. Someone in your production staff asked me to bring my camera along, though.
Oh, yeah, that. Now, the fellow that produces the show you're going to be doing is a camera buff. Don't let him get too involved in that technical stuff, okay?
I got it.
All right, you hang on here. I'll go and get someone to take you to the makeup.
Thanks a lot, Tom.
Okay.
Hi, Cord. How's it feel to be hero for a day?
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, last I heard, it was a free country.
I've got nothing to say to you, Patrick. Just stay out of my face, all right?
You know, Cord, I really can't believe you're the kind of person that's going to take up an old lady's paranoid crusade to destroy me.
If you're innocent, you'll be able to prove that, right?
You can't prove I'm guilty, but that hasn't stopped you from accusing me. Now, you know, Cord, Elizabeth has more enemies than you can count, pal. And most of them would like to see her dead. The only reason that she's trying to point the finger at me is because she wants to get rid of me now that the burn formula's completed. So don't be a fool, Cord. You can't trust Elizabeth. She'll turn on you just exactly the same way she turned on me.
Say, I thought you'd left already.
I decided to hang around and congratulate Mr. Courage here.
Ah.
Listen, are your makeup people ready for me yet?
Sure, it's right back this way. Listen, why don't you just leave your camera gear right here somewhere on the set? You'll be fine.
Fine.
First time we made love?
It wasn't that long ago.
I know that. It just seems like we've been together forever.
Are you saying you're bored of me already? Is that it?
No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying it's really nice, you know? I mean, I feel very comfortable with you, yet this is all very new and exciting.
Yeah.
I think that's a pretty magic combination, don't you?
Oh, I think it's pure magic.
Mm-hmm. Max,
we
gotta get up.
Why? Why not? You don't want to.
Well.
It's
not that I want to. I mean, I would love. Trust me.
Oh,
I would love.
Sounds good to me.
I would love to stay here all day, right here with you.
Mm-hmm.
But, you see, I promised Vicky, you know, my sister, that I would help her with the Thanksgiving preparations. Mm-hmm. And if I don't show up, then I'm going to seem like I'm just as much of a flake as you are.
Okay, all right. Okay, you win.
Besides,
what?
You have got a hotel to run, so don't you go trying to make me feel guilty. And?
And what?
I also seem to remember something about you contributing some fabulous Thanksgiving punch.
That's right. I'll have you know that I gave the list of ingredients to the chef. He's boxing them up for me. All I gotta do is mix them up.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
And tell me, is it really that good?
Good. Let me tell you something, lady. Once you get a taste of my secret punch, you're gonna have a smile on your face the rest of the week.
Hold it. You make your own hours these days, Mr. Coleman.
Sir, I'm really sorry. I'm
late. Scheduled to set up for Court Roberts' interview.
Oh, man.
Hold it. It's too late. It's finished. And if you're late much more, young man, you're going to end up without a job. All right?
Yes, sir. I'm sorry. It won't happen again. I've just been looking for Mary Lynn all over town. I've left tons of messages at her dorm, at campus.
I see. Well, her message for you is she doesn't want to see or hear from you ever again. You understand that? I think that's the smartest thing she's done this year.
So,
ever brought up stocks and bonds before?
No, no, never. Not until this morning.
Oh, God, you know what this means?
It doesn't mean anything. This whole thing is a coincidence.
How can you say that? Why did you rush over to see me then?
Because what's so weird is he didn't ask me for the money. He just shrugged it off.
Of course not. He figured you'd feel sorry for him and then just give him the money.
No, but I didn't. I just shrugged it off, too.
Oh, yeah, well, he figured you'd think about it and then give him the money. This way it looks like your idea. Don't you understand, Cassie? You're dealing with a very experienced man here. He knows exactly what buttons to push to get what he wants from you.
Oh, man, I can't believe this is happening
to
me.
Well, you better believe it. And you better get yourself out of that loft and move back into the penthouse with me.
Melinda, I can't just walk out on the man. I love him. Now, look, look. Maybe we're just freaking out here. We're letting our imaginations get the best of us, you know?
Oh, honey, I know how you
feel. No, you don't know how I feel. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I am. I don't know which way to turn.
Well, maybe you should just get yourself together and I'll take you to lunch.
No, I can't turn my back on this. This is the man that I was planning on spending the rest of my life with.
Well, if you don't trust him now.
No, that's what I have to find out. Whether or not I can trust him, and there's only one way to do that. I'm going to give him the $100,000.
How long will you be staying, Miss Sanders?
I don't know.
Well, the suite is yours for as long as you like.
Thank you.
Kate? Hi.
Hi.
You checking in here?
Yeah, why?
Well, we'll be neighbors now.
I thought you had an apartment across town.
Yeah, well, I did, but I gave it up. I got tired of cooking and cleaning for myself, so I moved in here. I thought I told you that.
No. No, you didn't.
Well, I guess we've had more important things to talk about, haven't we? You look tired, huh?
Yeah, I didn't get much sleep last night.
I can understand why. So what did you do? Did you check in here to get away from everyone? Some time to yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember you disappeared on me a couple of times.
Yeah, you never minded.
Well, if it works for you, go for it. Look, Kate, I'm real sorry about your grandmother. I know how much you love her.
Oh, you know, it just makes me so angry that I listened to all those lies from her. I don't think that I can ever forgive myself for giving up on you, Patrick.
Kate, don't blame yourself, okay? And those 5 years are gone now, and no amount of guilt or blame or anger or anything else are gonna get them back for me. So I just have to look forward now.
Right.
I have to look back.
Defending yourself against an attempted murder charge, that's really something to look forward to.
Katie, I swear I didn't try to kill your grandmother. Somehow I'll find a way to prove that. But as long as you believe in me, then at least that's something to be thankful for.
Oh, thankful. Right. Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, same to you. Hey, will you have dinner with me tonight? Look, I promise it won't be depressing. We'll just talk about the good times we had and all the silly things we used to do.
I can't. I really want to be alone.
I understand. So did you bring your bags? Or?
No, no. I'm gonna go home and pack now.
Oh, okay. Listen, if you need to talk, I'll be here. All right.
Thanks.
Look, I got a little job for you, okay?
Hi.
Where then? I didn't ever think I'd see you again. Here you are.
I'm here to see my father. Excuse me.
Listen, you gotta believe me. Nothing is happening with me and Billy.
Oh, right. She was hired as a housekeeper, and that's why she was wandering in your room in her underwear.
Listen, nothing happened. I just said that. She just showed up and things...
Oh, and you just figured, why not, right?
You know how I feel about you.
I thought I did. Guess I was wrong.
Please, just, you have to believe
me. Wait, please don't
do
this.
No, wait. Don't you have any work to do? All right, sweetheart. You all right?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm fine. I just stopped by to ask you if you're gonna have time for Thanksgiving dinner.
Well, you bet. I'll leave early. I'll get there in time to help you with the church.
No, I'm gonna be doing all the cooking. It's gonna be very special.
Oh, lovely.
Especially since Mom has decided to join us.
I'm not sure that's a very good idea, sweetheart. Besides, I'm surprised that she'd care to have dinner with you knowing I was gonna be there.
Well, she didn't want to at first, but I convinced her to do it. Dad, believe me. I'm going to make it very special for both of you.
Honey, your mother probably wouldn't likely rather have dinner with someone
Mom
else.
Mom is going to have dinner with us, and that's it. Now, promise me you will try to get along with her. Dad, please.
Of course, honey. Yeah.
Oh, I love you.
I love you.
Your appointment. Mrs. Sykes still giving you a hard time?
I didn't see Mrs. Sykes.
Oh, really? Oh, a new client? That's great. Who is it?
John, I had some personal business to take care of.
Oh.
I had to go to the bank.
Well, why didn't you just go to the cash machine? It's a lot easier, you know.
John, you know, my mom left me a trust fund and...
Yeah, I know that.
You do?
Well, yeah. Doreen told me she wanted to leave you a nice little nest egg to fall back on in case you didn't want to work.
Well, it's not exactly a little nest egg, you know.
Yeah, I know that, too.
You also know how much I am so in love with you.
Well, of course I do. Come on, Cassie, you've never been reluctant to share your feelings with me, you know.
Well, that's my whole point. I want to share everything with you, John. What's mine is yours.
Well, Cassie, that's a very nice gesture. Thank you.
Well, actually, it's a little more than a gesture. I went to the bank and... I had a cashier's check drawn up for $100,000 so that you can play your hot stock market tip.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Cassie, I can't take your money. Look, I'll just ask Judith to loan me the money. I mean, she'll never miss a measly $100,000, and she's got a little gambling blood in her veins anyway.
You're right. Yeah. Okay. Whatever you say, that's fine by me.
Really? Yeah. Maybe I will take you up on your generous offer then. I mean, it's going to take a while for her check to transfer into my account, and I can deposit this check right away. But, sweetheart, that is really... Oh, that's very nice of you. I want to give you some collateral, though.
A begonia. Payson? Hi, I thought you were still at work.
I was, but I couldn't concentrate, so I came home.
How'd your interview go?
It went fine. Honey, we need to talk.
I really just came home to get a few things.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you did. I know that you need to work these things out by being off by yourself, honey. But I need to talk about them.
Not now.
Yes, now. Honey, we can't go on like this. I need to know what you're thinking, what you're feeling right now. I want you to know what I'm feeling. Honey, I keep thinking that if we're going to slip apart like this, there may not be anything that we can do to bring it back together.
Look, you have to deal with things your way right now. I've got to deal with this situation the way I know how.
By running off and hiding over at the waterside.
Frankly, I would like to leave town and everyone in it.
Everyone, huh?
Yes. I ran into Patrick today, and I think you should know that he's living at the waterside inn, too.
Since when?
I have no idea.
All right, look, honey, even though I don't like the idea of you leaving town right now, maybe you ought to go back to the airport and get a ticket for Hawaii or someplace like that.
What?
What?
Honey, I'm telling you, the man is dangerous. By moving into the waterside, living right next door to him, you're
only
asking for trouble.
What I am not in the mood for, listening to you and Patrick and Grams sit around accusing each other of every crime under the sun. Excuse me.
Will you listen to me?
No.
Kate! Please!
So, Doc, what kind of drugs can I get for you?
No. I don't need any drugs. I want you to get a camera for me, okay?
Hey, Doc, I'm your friendly pharmacy man. I'm not your personal shopper.
Be quiet. I can't be linked to this camera anyway. You understand that?
I don't get it.
This is the one I want you to get for me. Now, make sure it's this exact model. Go to a pawn shop, a repo house, find me a used one in top condition.
Hey, there's plenty of guys around who can do this kind of favor.
Archie, I don't have time to look around Landview for somebody I can trust.
I can't make my living hot-footing around for a camera.
This should take care of it for you. After you get the camera, we'll talk about the chemicals you're going to get for me. You got it?
Got it.
Bill Cosby.
Oh, that looks sensational. I hope you'll accept that as collateral for the $100,000.
John, when I had the check drawn, I didn't even think about collateral.
Oh, well, Cassia, this is a loan. Now, I know you said that whatever's yours is mine, but I'm going to pay you back. The fact is, any profit I make on this, we split 50-50. Fair enough?
Are you positive that this stock market thing is such a hot tip?
Oh, absolutely. Now, where's the check, sweetie? Come on, I got to get moving.
Great. Now, let's use the chair to your right as a starting point. Okay? And if the phone rings... Now, I want you to listen to the sound of my voice as I walk around the room. Do you know where I'm standing?
By the fireplace.
Terrific. You know, those are the first words you've spoken in 15 minutes. I'm glad to hear you still have a voice. You want to tell me what's troubling you?
It's enough for one day. Let's close up shop.
Thought you wanted to work on the staircase.
It's a holiday. You should be with family or friends or whatever.
Vicky invited me to stay for dinner, and I accepted.
Damn it! When are you going to back off and give me some space?
Now, Max, wait a minute. Now, if you change this dining room here into, like, old-time Mexico or Peking...
Oh, what a great idea. How did I not think of that?
Max, I should be home helping Vicky...
Help Vicky make dinner later on, okay? I have got a big surprise for you right here.
Well, I know. That's what you keep telling me. What is it? Do I have to guess what it is?
No. You just keep your eyes open and stay alert. Hey, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Kate.
Hi.
Oh, is that a room key you put in your purse?
Yes, it is.
Oh. Well, did you and Cord move back into his old suite?
No, we didn't.
Well, then why would you need a room key?
Well, I'm staying here to spend a few days alone.
Oh, no. Oh, my goodness. Did you and Cord break up?
We haven't split up, Tina. I just wanted some time alone.
Oh, what did you fight about?
We didn't have a fight.
Well, then why did you move out?
Tina, you're prying.
No, I'm not. I'm just trying to find out what's going on.
It's none of your business, darling.
Yes, it is. Cord is my friend, and I want to find out if there's anything I can do to help.
No, there really isn't anything you can do to help, but thank you so much for your concern.
Seems like trouble in paradise to me. You know, I think I'm going to go call Cord and find out if he needs anything.
Honey, if he wants to talk to you, he will call you. All right, now, will you forget about Cord and Kate and concentrate on us, huh? I got a big surprise for you. If you would just keep your eyes on the front door.
You know, you are incredible. You really are. I mean, you have given me a different surprise for every day that I have been out of prison.
Mm-hmm.
You just came in?
Wow!
Hello!
Hi.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Oh, honey, you raised it so I could see my... So I could see Al. Oh, hi, honey. How are you?
Bro, you all set?
Yeah, I think just about.
Oh, well, what? You changed your mind? You're going to have dinner with us so we can see Al?
Max, you didn't tell him.
No, I didn't. Darling, you see, Gabrielle and Steve are going to New York for Delilah's fashion show.
Yeah, I'm her assistant, and she's got some of my clothes in the line.
How long will you be gone?
Well, that all depends on how long I can convince this beautiful young lady to stay.
Tina, I don't think you're going to mind how long they're gone, because Al is staying right here in Lambview with his dad.
Oh, my goodness. I get to spend Thanksgiving with Al?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, thank you, Max. This is going to be the best Thanksgiving of my entire life.
Cassie, you're not having a change of heart, are you?
Can I ask you a question? Why did you give me a begonia? You know that it's really not one of my favorite flowers.
Oh, but it should be. I mean, look, this looks beautiful in your dark hair. And it smells all the fragrance of your perfume. It's as soft as your skin.
John, I have to tell you something.
Well, can't you tell me later? Really, sweetie, I gotta get to Burke's office. So if I can just have a check.
What is your big hurry?
Cassie, this is an opportunity of a lifetime.
Yeah, and there's a sucker born every minute.
Oh, come on, I've had a lot of experience at this thing, and I feel terrific about it.
You know, you never mentioned to me your interest in the stock market before. I mean, plenty of times my broker has called, and you've never had any suggestions. You've never asked questions.
Well, I never wanted to interfere.
Well, what kind of stock is this? I mean, maybe I'll call my broker and...
No. I'm buying plenty of stock for both of us. Really, I'll take care of it. And then you give me the check, I'll buy the stock, and we'll look at the stock report every morning together. Okay?
Okay.
Where are you going?
I'm coming with you.
Oh, no. Sweetie, we need someone to stay here and take care of the fort, so to speak. You handle whatever comes up, and I'll see you later, okay?
Well, hey, wait a minute. Aren't you forgetting something?
Thanks.
Clint, I assumed that Vicky told you I was staying for...
Well, you assumed wrong. Because you didn't. And if she had, I would have told her no.
Why?
Because I don't want this holiday dinner to be some kind of a test for me, that's why. I don't want you sitting there waiting for me to pour gravy on my cranberry sauce so you can chew me out in front of my family.
I will not put you through your paces at the table.
You couldn't be in the same room with me without coming off like some drill sergeant.
I do not understand this at all. I mean, I know you blasted me in the hospital because you were frustrated with your training, but, Clint, you're doing so well now. You have mastered almost everything that I've taught you, so where is all this anger coming from? I mean, to quote your favorite line, what the hell is the problem here?
You're the problem.
Why? Because I'm pushing you too hard?
Because you're taking over my life, Sarah. My home. And now my private time with my family, and I won't stand for it!
You are on the wrong line here, mister. I am not trying to take over your life or anyone else's. My job here is to train you and to help you become more accustomed to your blindness. I only accepted your wife's invitation because I thought I might get to know you a little better. My mistake. From now on, I will be keeping my distance.
Sarah? Sarah!
Nice going, Mr. Nice Guy. When are you going to learn to control your temper and
and realize that other people have feelings too. But that's not the whole problem, is it? How do you forget this cloud that's hanging over your head? I mean, how do you forget that you got a little piece of metal in your head that could move just the slightest little bit and you would be deader than a doornail? How do you forget something like that? What is the reason to even keep fighting one frustration after another when you could die any minute?
This is a bad time. I can come back.
No. Come in.
Where's your sister?
Oh, she's at work. Do you want a beer?
No. That's okay. I'm on lunch break. I gotta get back soon. I came to tell you something.
Oh, hey, listen. I accept.
What?
I accept your apology.
For what?
For blasting me at the Holden Towers when I came between you and Mary Lynn.
Let's not get into it about Mary Lynn, okay?
Okay, still hung up on the dits, huh?
Billy, just listen to me, okay? The cops are on my back. They're asking me a lot of questions about my friendship with Frank Montaigne. They want to know how I came up with that briefcase of money.
Wait a minute. The cop at the hotel said if you gave back the money, you wouldn't get into any trouble.
Yeah, I know that. But you see, Sid and Leonard are now claiming that the money belongs to them. They're saying that the money was hidden in their boss's club and I stole it.
And they believe those goons instead of you.
Yeah, well, you see, their lawyers are leaning on the cops and the cops are leaning hard on me.
But wait a minute. You only got that money to take to Frank Montaigne, but he got killed before
you
got a chance
to give
it to him.
Yeah, that's right, but I can't prove that, Billy. And I kind of lied. Not an out-and-out lie, but I said that the money was gotten from Frank Montaigne's shack. I didn't mention the club.
Okay, fine, listen. If they ask me any questions, I'll lie.
No, I don't want you to lie. Just lay low and don't offer any information, especially about that night at Frankie's, okay?
Okay.
Okay, you'll do that?
No, I can do that. No problem. Don't sweat it, okay? Hey, I'm cool. I'm cool. Besides, you know that you can always count on me.
That's great. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate it.
Listen, I want to stay for lunch?
No.
I can make some chili dogs.
I gotta go. I'll see you, huh?
Sure. No problem. Still got it bad for the little princess.
Hello. Now, if you tell me that you have to have your gray suit when we go to New York, then, honey, I'm in big trouble.
You're in big trouble, lady.
Oh, no. Well, then how about the dark blue?
Dark blue it is.
Mm. Well, Kip, what a pushover you are.
Hey, I'm a man about to embark on a second honeymoon with this beautiful, talented wife.
Oh, well, wait a minute. Let's do the fashion show first and then the honeymoon because, you see, I'm a little bit nervous.
Yeah, well, I know just the thing to calm your nerves.
Oh.
Now, honey, your fashion show is going to be a smash. You'll be the toast of New York.
My apologies, Captain, but if you don't do something about this trash, I will, and I guarantee it won't be according to the rule book. I think I'm going to go see how Sammy's doing with the desk sergeant.
This won't take long, Delilah.
It's okay. Well?
Somebody around here has got a nasty sense of humor.
It is not funny. It's disgusting, and I've had it with this joker. This is the third time this week I've opened my locker and found one of these cartoons. It implies I'm being considered for detective because I'm a woman and I'm sleeping with the brass. The women on the force put their lives on the line every day, just like the men, and we deserve respect just like the men. And if it takes beating some heads against the wall...
I don't think that's necessary.
You're absolutely right, Captain. I'll track down this creep and bring him up on department charges. I know it might hurt my chances for promotion, but I'm willing to risk it.
It won't hurt your chances. As a matter of fact, you're down to...
You think this isn't important enough to fight? You think it's harmless fun? Well, you're wrong. It's insulting, humiliating, and it hurts like hell.
No, I understand.
It's a subtle reminder that we should stay in our place. Women aren't supposed to be cops. We're supposed to be mothers or typists or telephone operators.
Yeah, well, I happen to believe that a woman deserves an equal chance at any job, including detective.
Well, I just can't let this go. I know you probably think I'm off on one of my crusades,
but
the thing...
You've made detective, Officer Chiantano. What are you...
If I don't fight this now, the other female cops will feel that I've let them down, and then I won't have...
Stacy, listen up.
What?
I recommended your promotion to detective, and the commissioner accepted my recommendation. Congratulations, detective.
This is ridiculous. I know John as well as I know myself. I can trust him. So he gave me a begonia. That doesn't mean he's the mysterious begonia gigolo who courts women, robs them blind, then ditches them. He loves me. He'd never do that to me.
This is not true. It's not true. It's not true.
Tahiti? Oh, congratulations, Stacy. I'm so proud of you.
Thanks.
Really, Rafe said that you scored the highest on the exam.
Yeah, she's got 4 citations for bravery. She's an expert marksman.
Enough. I can't stand it anymore. Oh, God, I don't know what to say to you except thank you and thanks for listening to my tirades.
Hey, the detective squad can use someone with your kind of passion. I think maybe you can shake some of the old boys up, huh?
Yes, sir.
So.
I think I can. Who will I be working with?
Ed Hall.
Oh, I know I'm dreaming now.
No, it's a fact. He's off today, but I called him to give him the good news. I hope you don't mind his hearing it first.
Well, I guess I better hit the files and find out what he'll be working on.
Listen, I'll tell you what. You're at the end of your shift. Why don't you take the files home with you and... read them there.
Thanks, Captain.
Sure.
I can't wait to tell my sister the good news.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, same to you.
Congratulations again.
Thank you. Captain, I won't disappoint you.
I know you won't. Oh. You want me to do something about this?
You've already taken care of it. I don't think that Joker will be drawing any more cartoons.
So proud of you.
No, how come?
For giving Stacy that promotion.
Hey, she didn't get it because she's a woman. She got it because she deserves it.
Yeah, well, more women should have bosses like you. Oh, now, wait a minute. I can't get started in this. I've got to get Sammy to the babysitter and get over to Vicky and Clint for dinner. Can you make it, maybe?
Yeah, I think so. Listen, while I'm on the subject, where are your keys? I want to get Smitty to pick up your car, take it to the garage. He can work on it while you're in New York, all right? And I'll get one of the squad cars to drive you over to the Cedar and over to Lanfair, all right?
Here you go.
Thanks, pal. I'll go out with you. Say goodbye to Sammy.
Thank you, guys.
Who's that?
Hi, Clint, it's Kate.
Oh, Kate, come on in.
It's a little late, but welcome home.
Oh, it's good to be home. Have a seat.
Actually, I came to see Vicky. Is she around?
She's in the kitchen. Did you come over to help with the preparations?
No, I came to tell her that I won't be able to join you for dinner.
Oh, no. She's going to be very disappointed, Kate, and so am I. I think of you as family, and I was looking forward to having the family together.
Well, it's a really sad time for my grandmother, and I feel like I should be with her.
Oh, Kate, let me work my way over the telephone. I'll give her a call and ask her to join it.
No.
It's no problem. I learned how to dial in the hospital.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, don't invite her.
You know, I can't see you, but I can still hear, and I hear something wrong in your voice. What is it?
Nothing, really. I have a lot on my mind, that's all.
It's not, Elizabeth, it's not the reason for your turning down the invitation, is it? Is it me? Do I make you uncomfortable?
Oh, God, no, it's not that at all. It's Cord. We're having some problems.
Oh, what kind of problems?
Oh, come on, Clint. You've got more than enough to handle right now.
Cord is my son, Kate. I'm very concerned about his happiness and yours. Now, come on. I'm a good listener. Come on over here and sit down and talk to me. You know, I still got an awful lot of horse sense up here, and maybe I can help you. At least let me try.
Now, he doesn't like strange peaches, and he gets up at 4 o'clock in the morning wanting his bottle.
Al, Gabrielle, there's nothing you can tell me about Al that I don't already know. Remember, I took care of him for some time, remember?
I know, I remember, and you were wonderful with him, but I still worry about him.
Well, don't worry, he's going to be just fine. Besides, you're going to have Steve with you, and Max and I are going to take wonderful care of Al, so you just go and have a wonderful time in New York.
What is this stuff? I mean, does Al need all this?
Hey, relax. Everything we packed is an absolute necessity.
What is with all these diapers? I mean, I'm getting a little nervous about the number of diapers we have.
He's going to go through those in no time, honey. Oh, and besides, we got plenty more in the nursery.
And he's teething right now, so he gets a little fussy.
Oh, he does. He has teeth. Look at that. He's got teeth.
Sweetie, we have a lot to do before we get to the plane, so maybe we should go, huh?
Hey, you guys, you have a real ball. Is this it? Is this everything we need?
All right, I'll get the stroller. Let's go. Fine.
Okay, don't worry. You're going to have a wonderful time. Come on,
got it.
Oh, is it Al's got teeth. Hi. Hi. Oh.
Hi.
So what happened next?
He just flew out of the office.
You let him get away with $100,000?
Melinda, I am sure he's at the stockbroker's.
Fine. Then we'll call and find out.
I don't know what number to call.
You mean John didn't tell you who it was? Well, you didn't ask who it was?
He said the guy's name was Burke. I thought this Burke guy was a client. I looked it up. No, Burke. Maybe Burke is his first name.
I can't believe this. This is getting worse by the minute. John has copied the golden tip begonia gigolos patterns down to the last detail, and if I were you, girl, I would go to the police, and I would catch that man before he gets on the next plane to Tahiti.
I called the airport. He's not scheduled to leave any flights out of Landview either today or the next week. He is not leaving, so what now?
If you were leaving town with someone else's money, would you give the airline your real name?
You know, I knew I shouldn't have talked to you about this. All I do is get bummed out. Okay, I'm going back to the office to wait for John, and I'm sure that he's going to show up with the stock market purchase in his hand, and I'm going to feel dead guilty about accusing him, and I'm going to have to confess to him all my suspicions.
Well, I'm going to go call and find out when the next flight to Tahiti is.
In an hour and 5 minutes. So I memorized the flight schedule.
You better listen to me, girl. You better go find that guy before it's too late.
Right.
The music 2 blocks away. Can't you keep it down?
Sure, why not? Why don't I just take the tape out and then I'll play another one as long as I live? Would that make you happy?
Billy, why do you make me do this?
Why do you get on my case every time you walk through the door? I mean, can't you just lighten up?
Who can lighten up? The place is a wreck. You're driving the neighbors nuts with the loud music. You shouldn't even be home anyway.
I know. Please, don't start in on the why don't you go out and get a job lecture. For your information, I have been looking all morning, and I am here to report to you that there's nothing available.
Then go back to school.
You know, I told you a million times, I'm not into the college scene. Please, why don't you just get off my case?
Billy.
I know. You do it because you love me. Please, don't love me so much.
Honey, I believe in you, and I can't stand seeing you waste your life this way. If you weren't so bright, maybe it wouldn't matter, but you can be anything you want to be. You've just got to set your sights on something and go for it.
I'm working on it.
It would help if you stopped hanging out with those jerks over at that makeshift gym.
No, come on now. Don't look down your nose at my friends. Just because you're a blue uniform, you think every kid that wears funky clothes and has long hair is a jerk.
Not true. But your pals at the garage are losers, babe. And for your information, I'm not a blue uniform anymore.
You're not? Oh! Oh! I don't believe it. Oh, happy news at last. You know, I hated to admit that my sister was a cop.
Billy, I'm still a cop, but I just got promoted to detective.
Clint, I really appreciate your concern, but I don't think that there's anything that you can do.
Well, give me a chance.
I just think it's something we have to work out together. We had a huge disagreement about my grandmother and Patrick, and it got a bit out of control, and now I'm living at the Waterside Inn.
Do you still love Court?
Yes, I still love him. I just feel like the only way to protect that love right now is for us to spend some time apart, to let things cool off.
Hmm. Is Tina part of this?
Well, she's one of the reasons I'm not coming to dinner. I still have a really hard time seeing them in the same room together.
Kate, Cord has had an awful lot of suffering this year. I mean, he lost the baby, and then he lost his mother, and there were terrible circumstances that led up to her death, and now he has to deal with my blindness. And if you were to leave him, I mean, I know he could be stubborn as a mule sometimes.
No, and so can I.
Well, you don't want to live the rest of your life in a Mexican standoff, do you?
No, I just need some time.
Well, I need some... I need to know that you'll stick by him, that you won't leave him.
I promise you, I will never, ever leave him.
Good. And if you ever want to talk some more, I'm right here.
Thanks.
Clint! Oh, hello, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Larry.
Larry! Good to see the big guy home, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm gonna go find Vicky.
You take care, Kate.
I will, and thank you.
Well, I guess you decided to spend the holiday with us after all.
Oh, no, I can't. Unfortunately, I'm covering for a couple of doctors with wives and kids, and...
You're a hell of a fellow, Larry.
Yeah, listen, Clint, I've been thinking a lot about your situation.
But you haven't been... You haven't been able to come up with a way to remove the fragment.
No, believe me, I wish to God I could, but we just can't.
So we just keep the secret and hope for the best.
See, that's what I want to discuss, Clint. I don't think we can keep this a secret any longer.
John, what are you doing here?
Well, I was just going through some files.
Yeah, well, I went by your place. I was looking for your suitcase, as a matter of fact. I thought maybe someone broke in and stole it, along with all your clothes.
Well, I can explain
all
that.
Good, maybe you can start with why you're not with your stockbroker friend. Then we can move on to that Hawaiian shirt and the suitcase packed with practically everything you own. Taking a trip, perhaps? Maybe to Tahiti?
Tahiti?
Yeah, you dropped your travel brochure. You know, you made